recognize my wife, Carol. Have now come to around to the point of saying these wars that we're fighting in the Middle East and around the world make no sense whatsoever.
End the wars! End the wars!
They claim, and they're still teaching this in the schools, and they're still said, well, we finally got out of the Depression when a war came. And there's some who actually believe that if you have war, you can get out of a depression. War is never an economic benefit to anybody. And dying for some reason that is not important to our national defense. So this is the crisis that we have faced, that we've overextended ourselves, and we have to make this decision. For me, it's very simple. We should mind our own business and just come home.
Bring them home!
We're told we're in perpetual war, war forever, any place in the country. It's a war against potential terrorism, and they can't define terrorism. Terrorism is still defined in a dictionary, in our code, an international code, as a criminal act. But now we have drones all over the world. We bomb any spot that we want, and then we wonder why we have enemies around us wanting to do us harm. We invade their countries. We occupy their countries. There's a lot of collateral damage, and people die. And then they wonder why they might be annoyed. And then I imagine a few of you have heard the response at one of the debates when I suggested, why don't we think about foreign policy with a golden rule attached to it?
Yay! Yeah, they booed you. They booed you. What's wrong with them people?
I'm glad your response was much more favorable than I got.
Yes. We love you.
Why shouldn't we look at it that way? Why should we do anything to another country that we would be furious that they did it to us? And the other, we're now doing the same thing with the Iranians. The war drums are beating. And every single day, it's war propaganda.
No
war. We are not under a threat by the Iranians. If the Soviets weren't enough to have a conflict with them when they had so much in the height of the Cold War, this whole idea that we have to have another war, it will bring us down financially. And we have to wake up and tell our representatives, we don't need another war. We need less war.
Yes! Iran! No more wars! No more wars!
Like I say, but we can improve on it. We don't have to go back to an old gold standard. We can improve on another gold standard. It wasn't perfect. But the ultimate test of this is what the founder said. Ultimately, it depends on the morality of the people. Nobody's going to... Freedom doesn't work if the people aren't willing to accept the principles of freedom and assume responsibility for themselves. If they think that all we have to do is get together and hire more lobbyists... See, the business community are the most guilty right now because they have spent more money on lobbying than they do on R&D, and they want to influence government. And so... If we had this confidence, it would be completely different. We'd have a very small government. We would have a strong national defense. We would be tolerant of other people. We would have a lot more freedom. We would have a lot more prosperity. And one thing for sure, we would have a lot more peace in the world. And that is my goal, peace and prosperity. Thank you.
Home before they're dead. Max and the Fed. Max and the Fed.